Hello, people of God. We thank God for such another beautiful day, another part in the presence of God. Moses said, I will not go until your presence goes with me. It is the presence of God that makes the difference. Remember, I keep saying, it is in God that we live. We can only live in God. Some people are walking dead, you see. It's only in God that we can actually live, move, and have our being. Basically, it is in God that we can do all things. The Bible puts it in other words, we can do all things through Christ who gives us the strength. Without the strength of God, we cannot do it. I must touch again on the fivefold ministry. Like I said, there's various gifts that God has given the church. But this fivefold ministry, the ministry of teachers, pastors, evangelists, prophets, apostles, are the specific ones I believe God and the Bible has clearly stated, so that the body of Christ may be built up. We are the body of Christ. Christ is the church. And I said, when I enumerated earlier, that the body of Christ does not, you know, include one denomination, but all various denominations. But Christ came and died for all. He said, for God so loved the world that he gave. For God so loved the world that he gave. For God so loved the world that he gave, that whoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. Yesterday I was just watching one man of God, you know, doing an online healing service. And I believe the Holy Spirit was so strong, the presence of God was so strong, I was being healed. The Holy Spirit was working and I was being healed, even though I did not know that I was even sick. You see, but you know, I know my body so well that, you know, when I'm not well and, you know, the healing is taking place, I can sense or I can feel the symptoms that's coming out. And I could see or I could sense and, you know, feel some of the symptoms that, you know, usually when I'm not well and I'm coming around being healed, I feel, you know, in my body, or I try to, you know, sense in my body. I really thank God for, you know, the people of God, those especially in full-time ministry. I continue to pray that God will uphold them and empower them to continue to do the work. But like I said, so that their purpose and their reason is so that the body of Christ may be built up. As much as I didn't know, and God used it, like I said, each time you sit in the presence of God, you know, through anyone that God is going to use, you know, the focus should always be on God. And we thank God for the vessels that he uses. And that has actually availed themselves to be used. We bless them for their lives. And may God bless them. God knows how to bless them for that reason. But the focus should be on God. And I believe, like I said, it's so that the body of Christ may be built up. They also, you know, they are there to also empower you, you know, to also be able to stand and pray. I can tell you, you know, from point go, that there's been many times I have prayed for myself for healing as well, and God has healed me many times. And there has been many times men of God, powerful women of God, have also prayed for me and I've been healed. And there's been many times I have prayed for others that has also been healed. So, like I said, they are there for us to be built up. You know, if they are continuing to build us up, and you are still staying the way you are, then the purpose of God is not being accomplished. But remember, any letter of God's word has been put there that none of them will fall to the ground, but for it to be, for you to accomplish the purpose for which it was sent for. God's word is true. Like I said, he's not a man that he will lie, nor the son of, so that the body of Christ may be well. Because there's coming a time in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of the night, you know, in circumstances where there will be no man of God. You will be the man or the woman of God, because God has called you to be built up, to be able to take charge. You will be the one taking charge, praying for the sick, praying for yourself, and pray, you know, that healing will come. In fact, the Bible has said healing is the children's bread, basically. So it's something that is to be common to the children of God. And God, Jesus, I wish above all that you be healed. I wish above all that, you know, you prosper and be in health. Health is God's plan and God's purpose for his own children. Even as your soul prospers, God wants us to prosper in his presence. we thank God, we bless you. We say, God, continue to empower us for the purpose for which you have called each one.